दिस इज माई थर्ड वीडियो अबाउट द रॉयल एनफील्ड कॉन्टिनेंटल जी टी. आई एम गोइंग टू इंट्रोड्यूस यू टू द पिलियन सीट ऑफ द कॉन्टिनेंटल जी टी. एज यू कैन सी द पिलियन सीट एक्चुअली कम्स विद अ हुड. दिस इज द हुड ऑफ द पिलियन सीट दैट यू कैन अनस्क्रू एंड टेक आउट. सो आई हैव एक्चुअली अनस्क्रूड इट. सो आई जस्ट शो यू हाउ इट अपियर्स व्हेन यू रिमूव दिस. So this is the pillion seat. It's a bit longer than the previous one. The previous one ended until here, where only one person could use it. Removing the seat is quite easy in the Continental GT. You just need to put your key here, remove this panel, and there's a small wire that you need to pull, and you can remove this seat easily from there. I have placed some extra attachments on this bike. One is the backrest that's there. This is the stock one that comes with the Continental GT. However, I feel that this should be a bit more higher, because when I had people sitting on the pillion seat, I had received feedbacks from them that their back was paining since it was sitting on that backrest. So probably you can use a bit higher one, the one that's used in the Thunderbird. That would be more easy for them. Or you could have something custom built that could extend until a bit back, and it doesn't hit the people. Apart from that, I have also put a guard here. The ladies in India who often wear saris, their saris would get stuck inside the wheel, so this normally prevents that. Also, it helps you to put some luggage on this side, and it doesn't get inside. So that's an extra attachment. And since it's a pillion seat, I have also put the footrest for people to sit here. The common feedback that was given by the passengers was that it's quite comfortable on the pillion end. However, it should if it would have been a bit longer, that would be more comfortable, as well as about this backrest. I'll give you more feedback once people have ridden it quite frequently and over long distances. Thanks.